Right, it's back. Stop panicking. Right. The GT3 gas turbine locomotive was tested on the Woodhead line in the early 1960s. This scenario showcases a GT3 hauled express passenger service from Sheffield to Manchester, calling at Penistone. Open the doors, the scheduled departure time is 17:30. So if you haven't seen this train yet, this is the gas turbine. Looks like, is it a steam train? No, it's a gas jet. Kind of our version of the Union Pacific gas turbines. That's unnecessary. Sour grapes, I think, from somewhere. What train in TS have I driven the most? I've no idea. No idea. I'll have to have a look, because Steam, the game will tell you. Right away, driver. Once the brakes are finished coming off. Personally, I should also check the signal. Yeah, okay. Being a Seth, it's not a steam engine. Honestly, it's not a steam engine, dude. I'll have to burn this on full. Action. Francois says on the stream the top three are the ES44 AC 20 times, the ES44 DC, and the UK Class 37 both 16 times. That's actually not what I was expecting. The S44 sounds good. That sounds likely, but I wasn't expecting the 37 to do so well. Oh, we've got a 30 limit. If you imagine really, really hard, it's a steam engine. No more so than an ES44 is a steam engine. Thank you. Oh, we've got a bit of parallel running here. Excuse me. Oh, so no, wait, you don't need to have a brake pan, do you? You're forgiven. That'll do. Spot the grog. Delta 2585, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Yeah, found the pause brake alternative case for laptops function right shift. I think that depends very much on the laptop, but it's good that you found it. That's good. Next station is Penistone in 11.7 miles. Dog Glacier at the world's largest model train store. Where is that then? You want a map, do you? There you go. The Woodhead line. Where are we? Down here. We just departed from Sheffield. I think Penistone's here, isn't it? Yep, Penistone's the junction here, and then we're making our way to Manchester over here. This scenario is by TobBirk, so I'm expecting good population of assets around the route. Denver, Colorado, superb. Like he's trying to escape the cab. No, he's managing the boiler. You look here. See him in there, look. Sounds wrong. The minute you blow the horn, you wish you hadn't. I want a really impressive chime whistle or something. But no, it's a class. It's like a class 37 horn. Offer him a cup of tea. I'm not sharing my tea. What do you think this is? Thank you. Hey Gouger, welcome. Does this have Woodhead Tunnel Company assume? Yes, it does, and I believe we'll be going through it because we're all the way to London, Manchester, London Road. So yeah, we should be going through Woodhead Tunnel, I think. What's the top speed of the GT3? I'm not sure. You have to ask Karma. He'll know. No, I didn't see it, Gouger. But I will definitely give that a run. Your other scenario went really well. Six miles to go. What period is the route set? I can't remember what period it is. It's like 70s or something like that. On the Isle of Man steam railway? No, I haven't. You could be right, Amaryl, and I really don't know this route very well. It's up north. My knowledge of things up north is not so good. The tender has got fuel in it and it's got the vertical boiler in it. Vertical boiler is used for heating the steam heating that works on the coaches. Fantastic route, isn't it, Flying Scotsman? It's one that I haven't really run enough of on the stream. It's one of the reasons I was quite keen to run this, not run the GT3, haven't really run the Woodhead route much. We've got 2.2 miles to Penistone, 60 limit. Task list, yes, passengers from Penistone and then pick up at London Road in Manchester. Way ahead of schedule, so I'm going to get the brakes coming on. Yeah, the window is quite small, isn't it? Over there. I was wondering what all that clattering and banging was. Get that dirty, horrible thing away from my lovely train. Moggy says, his interpretive dancing includes a repertoire of many movements, mainly involving pretending to be a tree. Yeah, you showed me about what it was like to pretend to be water at Brighton. That was just hilarious. You better behave on the stream or I'll share the video. The lights have gone off. Come back on, lights. Just steam chuffing for the win. Oh, yeah. Jelly Bean, when you say cab controls, do you mean these ones, or do you mean the ones inside the cab? If small children get sucked into the intakes. Right, from here, we're here, we're going to race all the way down here now. 28 miles. Uriel, oh, Woodhead route is gorgeous. It's a really nice, really nice route. In cab controls, better off, I did a demo of actually doing, because you've got all of the start manual startup controls here. Got off the top of my head, I can't remember how to use. This one I'm using is a brake, it makes the brakes come off a lot faster. This one is, makes that horrible noise. And you've got all the lighting controls, you've got the main throttle control, reverser. There's not a lot to it, to be honest. All the magic is going on under the hood. Get the 70 limit in a minute. Should be in 70 before I need to do any throttle adjustments. Ben, did I play ATS on Friday? I certainly did, and the pink pig was introduced to the world. Nico's Meow, does it come with a simple mode? You can run in the A2 in simple controls, yes. You can also run it without with automatic firing, so all you're doing is the expert controls, but without any of the firing stuff. So yeah, you should be fine. While we're doing this, tea time. Lovely, such a good route. Why do you sometimes go on the Twitch chat? I don't know what you mean, Nimmy boy. Fifty limit coming up. Whenever you see the cab, you just want to flick switches. Moggy, get off my Prius. Oh, sometimes I reply in the chat instead of verbally. I don't actually know quite why sometimes I type it and sometimes I say it. I'm just weird. Tea bag in the cup. Is this Woodhead Tunnel? I can't remember. I'm gonna get in trouble in a minute, aren't I? Jelly Bean, there are water troughs in Train Simulator. They're on the Riviera in the 50s line. Downhill now. There's nothing wrong, Karma. Messing with my head. Just keeping on my toes here, thanks, Karma. Montoxia cat has popped himself right in front of the stream and is watching. Hello, cat! Yeah, if it's getting behind Nimmy Boy, you just need to do a refresh and it'll reset it back to about 12 seconds. Up. See you later, Nimmy boy. That's harsh. Thank being kid, I suppose Southern Railway didn't have water for us because it didn't have a loco reliable enough to get to one. There is another version of this scenario which takes you the other direction, heading back to Sheffield from Manchester, which would then be mostly an uphill run. Can has tea. Got a 40 limit coming up. 13 miles, we're about halfway there now. Going to be speeding a bit as we hit the 40, but not too much. Okay, a bit too much. Oopsie. NSF says you can pick up a twin pack with this and the Thompson B1 for cheaper than the route by itself. Well, there you go. That's the nature of bargains. 7.4 to London Road. God, there's lots of gronks on here, only when I think that they knew Muggy would be watching. For some reason I thought I would be in the 75 by the time I got there. Now we're in the 75. I have no idea what my least favourite train is all clear simulations, to be honest. I kind of sort of... I find something I like in all of them. Limit coming up. Exit, this should be fine. I'll take a look at it. Favourite train has got four wheels, the pump cart. Oh, actually, I like the little 040 steam engines. The saddle tanks. Or are you talking about mine cart? Yeah, bundles will quite often be cheaper. Well, Pacer's on four wheels, I guess, per car, but actually it's eight cars. They're always in pairs, aren't they? So there'll be eight wheels. Oh, no, the Pacer's not my favourite, I just don't hate it. Seven miles to Manchester. getting a little bit busier around here now. Signal density's gone a bit, gone quite higher. A 35 limit coming up. We're going down a reasonably steep hill at the moment. Dropping down to the 35, come through here. The longest route in the game, I don't know for sure. It's either Canadian Mountain Passes, Donner Pass, or the Pietermaritzburg, Ladysmith, KwaZulu-Natal corridor. It's one of those three. They're all very long. I think it's the KwaZulu-Natal, which I think is 190 miles. Back up to the 35. 4.9 miles to go. Kickback man, yeah, I'm doing ETS. Got one more scenario to do, and then we'll be doing ETS. Oh, it's 191 kilometres, is it? Okay. That probably makes the Canadian Mountain Passes the longest then, doesn't it? I saw a double yellow coming around the corner there. Michael Keane 12, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Sounds like your vacuum cleaner. Switch off the vacuum cleaner. Slow down to 50. Oh, I need a bit more than that. Breaking. Oh, it's the blue 77. 2.6 miles to go. We're now being slowed down. We're in the area of Manchester. Railhead in the bottom corner of the screen. Yeah, down there, that's a speedometer. It's essentially a copy of that gauge. I can make it show any of the gauges that are on the control panel. German kilometers now, speedometer, ammeter, AWS, brake pipe, various brake pipe gauges, back to the speedometer. Goodbye, Ronic Gaming. Switching for life. Yeah, this is the rail driver you can buy. The gauges are from Cytec. They're for flight simulator, and then my dad built the wooden frame to put it all in. Because you seriously don't want to let me near wood. Me with wood and a saw is there's lots of sawdust and not necessarily anything productive at the end of it. And then it's all powered by custom software. Even the rail driver is being powered by my software as well. Because by default, these only work with Flight Simulator. And it's all running network. So this is actually not on my PC. It's on a different PC. It's a laptop over here. And then they're networked to make it all work. That way the load for sending all the data for these screens isn't coming off of the machine I'm using to play the game. London Roads just up ahead. Favourite German steam loco? It would be between the 86 and the 24. Possibly the 86. Oh yeah, it's all live feed out the game. There's a copy of the software running on the PC that runs here, and it's taking all the data out and putting any commands back into the game. There's then a network communication to the other computer, which runs another copy of the tool, and then that then interfaces it all over to the control desk. So essentially, this the control desk says, "Get me the speed," sends a message to the other to this machine, gets the speed out of the game, sends it back, and then this updates the rotation of the needle on the speedometer. And welcome to Manchester London Road. When you disembark, don't forget to take your belongings with you, or they're mine. Finders keepers, losers weepers. As soon as the doors close, too bad, so sad. Ponyman 6, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Hey there, T. Welcome. Briggsy asked about partnership. I've not heard anything back, so... I mean, I'm expecting it to be a no, but I've not heard anything back. Hey, Twitcher for life, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. I know the buffers are a long way away. Leave me alone. Kickback man. Yeah, Dovetail, let me apply for partnership. I'm already down as a YouTube partner. Oh, glad you're enjoying it, Twitcher for life. Get off my train. Oh, for goodness sake. Look, see? It's not that far away. Look, like 2 inches. Could park a coal train in that gap. Yeah, a really short one. Seriously, look, it's like 2 inches. That's all you can get there. Well done, thank you for driving. Superb. Right, so that was Passenger Express to Manchester by TobBirk. yes, that was awesome. Really enjoyed that. Right, changing route. Last scenario. What are we doing now? Berlin bound coal. Oh yes, Majestic Falls. We haven't run much with the SCB-1500 either, so that's why I quite like the idea of running this one as well. I'll even turn the screen back so that you can see it too. Look, see, aren't I generous? Good night, Monty.